Windows friends, bonjour à tous et à tous. It's a great honor for me to be pleased to speak to all of you today on the word written today, because we too often ignore or tend to forget the hardships, refugees, and the war. On oublie souvent les difficultés et les obstacles qu'un réfugié a dû subir, a dû surmonter, a dû vaincre pour s'établir et recommencer sa vie. En cette journée importante, je voudrais solennellement rendre hommage aux réfugiés, à la mémoire et à leur histoire. Chaque année, le 20 juin nous donne l'occasion de sensibiliser le monde entier à la cause de millions de réfugiés ayant besoin de protection. Je tiens à remercier l'honorable professeur Alexander, ministre de la Sécurité et de l'Immigration du Canada, pour son travail profondément dévoué à la protection des réfugiés. Merci monsieur le maire d'Ottawa, à son honneur, Jim Watson, pour son attention bienveillante envers de nombreux réfugiés qui s'adressent à Ottawa. And I saw it was my of the immigration officer. Mr. Malloy was here, but I have to thank Mr. Malloy too. Merci à Madame Lino Abouch, vice-présidente des commissaires et des maires de la section d'appel des réfugiés, pour son travail auprès de lui, de plusieurs demandeurs d'asile qui se représentent tous les ans au Canada. Et merci à vous, Monsieur Bill-Nicolas, de m'accueillir parmi vous, afin de célébrer une journée qui marque des milliers de familles canadiennes. Je tiens aussi fortement à applaudir ma collègue, sénatrice Jaffer, avec qui j'ai le plaisir de travailler avec elle, d'examiner de près la situation des réfugiés en Syrie, au sein du Conseil des droits de la personne au Sénat du Canada. Like my colleague from the Senate, I too first arrived in Canada. Well, every refugee story is unique. Your story, my story, but I'm not going to tell my story. And it is not for us to understand what experience of the refugees might like. How do you know why I landed in Canada? Well, I was interviewed by an immigration officer in Thailand, Bangkok. After examining all my paperwork, they say, well, I think you're suitable to come to Ottawa. And I say, where? She said, Ottawa, Canada. I say, okay. So why did I come to Ottawa? He said, do you know what? In Ottawa, you can go to work by skating on the canal. Imagine a person in Asia who said, well, the road is scary on the canal. I said, scary on the canal? It's not water? No, 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 because in the winter. So, okay. And during that time, I've been approached by Australia, Spain, France, where I study. And I refused them all when I came to Canada. And I'm lucky to be here in Canada. And the second story, very shortly, when I arrived here in Canada, I am traveling from Bangkok to Stockholm, I don't know where, in Korea, as well as London, in Vancouver. And then Vancouver missed the flight, catch up the next flight, and I arrived in Ottawa at 3 a.m. And there was no immigration officer. I don't blame you guys. There was nobody at the airport at 3 a.m. to welcome me or to take me in. After traveling nearly 40 hours with a wife and two kids, what do you think I'm going to do? I just asked this, I said, I'm going to get a taxi, and I told the taxi, take me to any hotel. Anywhere, I just want to see. Well, there's no way to do it. It's too late to shadow the game. Our first refugees sleep in Chateau Laurier for one night. And the next day when I get to the immigration officer, I had an Albert Street at that time, I think, the officer said, you get out right away. Well, that is the two memories I cherish a lot. But overall, being a refugee means escaping a devastating, life-thrilling environment, embarking on a perilous journey to safety and defeat, and establishing yourself in a totally different and unfamiliar environment. My story in Canada started when I came here in 1975, in a moment of great need Canada welcomed us. After we lived through the devastating war in Vietnam, suffering in refugee camps, and during our most trips to escape a place where we could no longer call home. Unlike Senator Jaffa, she had a chance to go back to Vietnam. I don't have a chance to go back to Vietnam. I have been invited out of the Vietnamese embassy to go back to Vietnam, saying, well, after you left Vietnam nearly 40 years, is a place for you to go back to visit. I said, no. I don't come back until you change, because I don't accept the communist regime. And once I don't accept it, I'm aboard. So since then, I've been here 40 years, and I put my foot in Vietnam and so on. After the Vietnam War, over 65 South Vietnamese were executed, and over 1 million were sent to prison and re-education camp, where it was estimated around 165,000 died because of retributions from the North Vietnamese communists. The years after the fall of Saigon from 1975 to 1996 was known to be the largest mass migration known in modern history, with more than 1.5 million people leaving their war-torn country in search for hope and freedom. Most of the forced migration, other often displaced from mountains and desert, the Vietnamese exodus was unique, because the only route to escape or fleeing the Vietnamese communist their country was by navigating through sea. This is why this group of refugees has become known to the world as the Hope People. Many Vietnamese refugees have set sail in a rickety broken boat for South China Sea, where they face constant, unimaginable peril. They had to navigate not only through deadly storm, but also through diseases and starvation. The primary cause of death of the Hope People was drowning, an attack by parrots, and murder of sold into slavery and prostitution. According to the United Nations High Commission for Refugees, over 255 Vietnamese poor people perished at sea looking for a bright future. After the fall of Saigon in 1975, Canada and Canadian gracefully opened their home and their hearts to over 60,000 Vietnamese refugees who desperately need a place to rebuild their lives. And just like so many other refugees, we had to work hard to rebuild our home, to establish ourselves and our family. Trust me when I say it is not an easy task. Arriving in the hardships. For many of us, it means leaving your home and sometimes your family behind. It means going back to school because your education was not recognized in Canada. It means working 2 to 3 jobs to make ends meet and provide for your family. It means learning a language. It means accepting a new culture without forgetting who you are or where you come from. And for all refugees in Canada, it means also facing a new season, which we call winter. And just like any other refugee story, the Vietnamese-Canadian journey and arrival to Canada is now part of our national heritage. Canada now is our home to many proud generations of families who arrived here first as refugees. They now celebrate an important heritage in a great nation and constantly show that they are hardworking Canadians capable of becoming an integral part of Canadian society. Since World War II, Canada has been known as the world leader in resettling refugees who fled their countries in search of freedom, security, and peace. Canada is recognized worldwide internationally in offering safe haven to more than 1 million refugees who brought their experience, hopes, and dreams to Canada, and who now help build an even richer and more prosperous society for all of us. To this day, Vietnamese poor people journey to Canada stand as one of many successful refugee stories. In 1986, the people of Canada were awarded the Nelson Medal by the United Nations High Commissioner for Refugees in recognition for their major and sustained contribution to the cause of refugees. The Canada fait preuve d'un refuge exemplaire et a rempli son rôle humanitaire avec courage dans de nombreux pays de réfugiés. Fidèle à son identité, le Canada est aujourd'hui à l'avant-garde de la protection des réfugiés. Nous sommes le droit de la personne dans le monde. On le constate en Syrie, où le Canada exerce encore une présence active pour la protection et le bien-être des réfugiés. En tant que réfugiés, beaucoup d'entre nous provenant de divers horizons aux quatre coins du monde. Et nous avons tous décidé, nous avons tous choisi de faire du Canada notre maison, notre foyer et notre nouvelle patrie. Le Canada est une terre d'immigration, une terre d'accueil. Nous avons une richesse, c'est notre pluralité. Cette pluralité qui nous rend si fière et si fort. Nous sommes chanceux de célébrer une si grande diversité et qu'il est notre devoir à tous de la protéger, de la faire grandir et de la renforcer. C'est donc avec fierté que je vous parle aujourd'hui à cette tribune afin de célébrer la journée mondiale des réfugiés, de vous rappeler qu'il y a encore toujours des millions de réfugiés dans ce monde et que le combat continuera en tant qu'il restera encore. In closing, I would like to point out that without Canada's generosity and humanity itself, nor thousands of refugees have achieved what we have today. Today, thanks to Canada's generosity and humanity, I am now able to fully rise as a senator and to defend freedom, human rights, democracy without fear. Today, I can look at my family and I say, I know I have been able to provide for them and ensure their well-being. I'd like to end by thanking all the participating agencies. And allow me again to thank all of you, for your support. I'm hoping here today, the celebration of the extraordinary courage and contributions of Eugene